say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turned to night. Darkness is not dark to you, Lord. The night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Your love, O Lord, abounds. 16th chapter, beginning in the 20th verse. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, "Separate yourselves from this congregation, so that I may consume them in a moment." They fell on their faces and said, "O God, the God of the spirits of all flesh, shall one person sin and you become angry with the whole congregation?" And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Say to the congregation, 'Get away from the dwellings of Korah, Dathan, and Abiram.'" So Moses got up and went to Dathan and Abiram. The elders of Israel followed him. He said to the congregation, "Turn away from the tents of these wicked men and touch nothing of theirs, or you will be swept away for all their sins." So they got away from the dwellings of Korah, Dathan, and Abiram. And Dathan and Abiram came out and stood at the entrance of their tents, together with their wives, their children, and their little ones. And Moses said, "This is how you shall know that the Lord has sent me to do all these works. It has not been of my own accord. If these people die a natural death, or if a natural fate comes on them, then the Lord has not sent me. But if the Lord creates something new, and the ground opens its mouth and swallows them up, with all that belongs to them, and they go down alive into Sheol, then you shall know that these men have despised the Lord." As soon as he finished speaking all these words, the ground under them was split apart. The earth opened its mouth and swallowed them up, along with their households, everyone who belonged to Korah, and all their goods. So they, with all that belonged to them, went down alive into Sheol. The earth closed over them, and they perished from the midst of the assembly. All Israel around them fled at their outcry, for they said, "The earth will swallow us too." And fire came out from the Lord and consumed the 250 men offering the incense. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exultat Spiritus Meus in Domino Deo, salutari meo.
night he would go out and spend the night on the Mount of Olives, as it was called, and all the people would get up early in the morning to listen to him in the temple. Now the festival of unleavened bread, which is called the Passover, was near. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to put Jesus to death, for they were afraid of the people. Then Satan entered into Judas, called Iscariot, who was one of the 12. He went away and conferred with the chief priests and officers of the temple police about how he might betray Jesus to them. They were greatly pleased and agreed to give him money. So he consented and began to look for an opportunity to betray him to them when no crowd was present. Then came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover meal for us, so that we may eat it." They asked, "Where do you want us to make preparations for it?" "Listen," he said to them, "when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house he enters, and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks you, where is the guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, already furnished. Make preparations for us there." So they went and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you and I set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see. A light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated on the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you,
and also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord, that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses. We entreat you, O Lord, that there may be peace to your church and to the whole world. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in the communion of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Evangelist, and all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ. We entreat you, O Lord. O Lord, make us have perpetual of your loving kindness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just works. Give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour. In the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this life, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, O Christ. Give rest to the weary. Bless the dying. Soothe the suffering. Pity the afflicted. Shield the joyous. And all for your love's sake.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing.